Windows 11 is officially out, but it may not be as easy to simply install or do a fresh upgrade as you think, because there are many hurdles that you're going to have to overcome to be able to install this OS on your system and have it up and going really good. Now, before I get started, today's video was inspired by an article that I saw on Ars Technica. I will have that link below. But before you go saying, hey, I want to install Windows 11, there are some facts that you're going to need to know before you do so. So let's talk tech. Did you just build yourself a brand new PC? Or did you just upgrade your old PC, but find you're in need of a Windows 10 key? If that's the case, your CD key has you covered. And buying, it's never been easier. All you do is go to your CD key website, find the Windows software that you want to buy, put it into your cart, enter the code TOT20, apply the code, save yourself some extra money, and as soon as you complete your purchase, the Windows 10 key will be in your inbox. There's no problems, it's really easy, and all keys are guaranteed to work, so you don't have to worry about losing your money, and you'll have a valid Windows 10 key to get your unit up and running. So Windows 11, it looks really cool. It's very Mac-ish, which I don't find a problem, but some users may. In fact, probably I see the future of Microsoft going to a completely Linux-based or Unix-based system in the near future. And Windows 11 is probably really the last OS that we'll see that's based on the x86 platform. Now, before we get started also, if you like my style, I'd really appreciate it if you like, share, and guess what? Sub to the channel. And when you sub to the channel, make sure you turn on that notifications bell or you'll never know that I'm making videos. So let's jump in and let's see about all of the hurdles that you'll have to overcome just to install Windows 11 on your PC. Windows 11 may sound appealing, but there are a few factors you need to consider before attempting to simply upgrade or do a fresh install. First off, there are new hardware requirements that may keep you from either upgrading or just doing a fresh install. So the first thing you need to consider are these basic system requires that are really high for Microsoft at this time. For the CPU, you need a 1 GHz or faster with 2 or more cores, x86, 64, or ARM 64 only processors. As far as the RAM requirements, 4 GB or more. But honestly, you guys know it's at least 8 GB even for Windows 10 to run properly. Now, as far as the storage goes, Microsoft says you need 64 GB minimum for installation. But honestly, I'd recommend at least 128 GB for a vaguely normal system. As far as the graphics go, it needs to be a graphics card that's compatible with DX12 or later with WDDM 2.0 drivers. Damn, that's pretty steep. Now the firmware has to be UEFI and secure boot capable. TPM, this is Microsoft's trusted platform module. You have to have version 2.0 because it's listed as the minimum requirement. TPM 1.2 may or may not be good enough, but don't give up just quite yet. And as far as the display goes, it says you need a 720p minimum resolution with a 9-inch minimum diagonal measurement and 8 bits per color channel or higher. That's not that bad. Pretty much we all have that. The problem is, that is not the only thing you need in addition to those strict hardware requirements. Windows 11 Home requires a dedicated internet connectivity and a Microsoft Cloud account both. The Microsoft account and internet connectivity are only mandatory for Home from what we know so far, but not Windows 11 Pro. Right now, who knows if there's even going to be a workaround. Like the current just unplug the network cable and wait until after installation trick. Now, although Windows 11 is setting the bar very high as far as components go, it may be possible that lower end hardware may still work. But the jury, it's still out on whether or not that pans out to be true. So with that said, we'll just have to wait and see what happens as many more users try and install Windows 11 on their older machines. But most likely, it will work, if not at its absolute best. If Microsoft codes a hardware requirement checklist into the installer or boot sequence, many CPUs that would have otherwise worked well will be unusable. That seems fairly unlikely, but that information is really on hold for now. Most do-it-yourself PC motherboards, even the best flagship boards, do not come with an installed hardware TPM module. But on the other hand, most of those boards do theoretically support hardware TPM using a special 19-pin header that is ready to plug one in. However, it's a very niche specialty device that few users have ever even thought of buying. Have you thought of buying one? I didn't. There were a few dedicated TPM modules available, but if you did not buy one, it's probably no sweat, as you most likely will not even need one. An OEM hardware TPM is considered the most hardened version, and it comes soldered directly to the board in PCs intended for enterprise use. Less hardened firmware TPM support is built right into modern AMD and Intel processors, and that will satisfy Windows 11's TPM requirements without issue. The main issue right now is it's just too early to have a complete list of boards that have the onboard firmware-based TPM. Mainly, that is due because the need for it was fairly low until this week, when Windows 11 was officially announced. As far as we can see, every x86 64 CPU on Microsoft's supported processor list includes that support, and I will have a link down below to that list just for you folks. Intel calls its firmware-based TPM IPPT Intel Platform Protection Technology, and AMD calls its own FTPM Firmware Trusted Platform Module. Generally speaking, IPPT shows up in most Haswell 4th generation core CPUs, although the K-series gaming modules unfortunately fail to get IPPT until Skylake, which is a 6th generation core CPU. On the AMD side, we see FTPM come with Ryzen 2500 CPUs and above. Although most of the semi-modern CPUs support firmware TPM, almost all motherboards ship with it disabled in the BIOS. What this means is you will have to navigate through your BIOS just to find the right setting to enable it. Just one more hurdle you need to do just to install a new OS. And for many users, this is going to be a pain in the proverbial ass. Unfortunately, many OEM motherboards will probably have the FTPM disabled by default, and what is worse is that on many boards, this option may be unavailable, especially on some systems by Dell and HP that will leave you out in the cold and unable to upgrade to Windows' latest OS. What you will need to do to determine whether TPM support is available and working under Windows is run the command prompt tpm.msc. This will show a TPM dialog that shows whether you have TPM support and what version, either 1.2 or 2.0. You can also interact with the TPM by clearing or preparing it, but that's not something you need to do or should do unless asked. Let's just face it, man. Messing with your TPM can permanently brick BitLocker volumes, and it might even deactivate Windows in some rare cases, which means, guess what? You'll be reinstalling Windows 10 anyways and losing all your information. Okay, so far, that's a lot of requirements, right? I mean, come on, it's not just a simple thing. But guess what? There's even more hurdles to overcome, so put on your running legs and let's continue. So now let's talk about UEFI and Secure Boot. Microsoft has listed Universe Extensible Firmware Interface, UEFI support, and Secure Boot capability as hard requirements for Windows 11. But just like with the CPU requirements, it's unknown how actual this really is. The requirement for UEFI is most likely to be just what it says on the label, which would mean no more legacy BIOS installs for anyone. But at this point, Secure Boot may be a bit of an overstatement, as capability may just be a word that is being overused. But honestly, until more users are trying to install it, we simply cannot say that is the fact at this time. Now, the good news is if you own a pre-built OEM PC, these requirements will probably have no effect on you, as any system with both CPU and TPM support modern enough to run Windows 11 will have UEFI firmware, and its current Windows 10 installation will be running on it. Owners of do-it-yourself systems, however, may run into a very annoying problem, as most enthusiast boards allow either booting from either BIOS or UEFI. And if you installed Windows under BIOS, you won't be able to simply convert it to UEFI. Now, with enough effort and technical ability, it's possible to Frankenstein a BIOS installation of Windows into new life under UEFI. But it's simply not going to be worth it for most Windows users, who will still need to do a complete clean reinstall. And this problem becomes even more significant for those running virtual machines. Several virtualization platforms, including Linux KVM, default to BIOS rather than UEFI boot for guest. It's simpler, it generally boots quicker, and it's been around for way longer. The motto, "Why fix something that's not broken?" actually comes to mind. If your daily driver Windows 10 VM is booting from BIOS, you'll be stuck with the same can't get there from here issues that PC builders who selected a BIOS boot had. Personally, I think Windows 11 looks great. All of the new features, the rounded edges, the center menu, all of that stuff to me is very appealing. The only problem is that to get Windows 11 on your machine, there are just so many things that you have to have that it's not just a simple thing to do. You're gonna have to make sure that you have all of those requirements and able for it to run properly on your system. Now, like I said earlier in the video, some of the hardware requirements you may get away with not having, especially when it comes to like older CPUs, there may be some workarounds. But right now, it's really, like I said, too early to know how everything is going to pan out. But if you're a fan of Windows, you're really looking forward to update, and honestly, a lot of us are always looking for something new, right? Then chances are that you're going to take the chance and install it. But please, just make sure that you follow along the lines that I talked about in this video so that you don't get stuck wasting your time or completely blowing out your system and end up reinstalling Windows 10 anyways and just wasting an extraordinary amount of your time. Also, like I said earlier, I will have links down to the Ars Technica, the original article that I got this idea from, as well as to links to all the different hardware requirements and the CPU requirements that are needed for Windows 11. So I'm Elric. You guys have been watching Tech of Tomorrow. You're an awesome audience. So peace out. If you don't have a dollar and you'd still like to support the site, I have a link down below where you can try Amazon Prime for free. And there are some really cool movies that are coming out on August 2nd that you're really going to want to check out. So right now is a perfect time to install and try it. Also, for a single dollar, you can support me on Patreon. And like I said, all of those Windows keys are guaranteed to work, or you have my personal money back guarantee. So we'll see you guys back here for more tech on Tech of Tomorrow. See ya! Bye-bye!